Hi, community group leaders and teachers. I hope you all are doing well and having a great day. Hey, I want to take a quick moment today for our Leadership Minute and spend just a couple of moments to encourage you, because I've heard that from a lot of you that it's difficult in this season with a lot of people that we've been called to lead and tasked to lead, not answering phone calls, not answering texts, not responding to emails. And we feel like as leaders that we're the only ones walking through this. Well, the truth is across the board, a lot of our community groups today are experiencing a decline in attendance. And some of that has to do, to be honest, with the time of year where people naturally go on vacation this time of year. And so they're unplugging a little bit, but some of that also has to do, if we're honest, with coronavirus. The people just don't know what to do. And they're tired of using Zoom. They're tired of using other mediums of communication. They just want to get together face to face, but they're still afraid to do so. Well, as a leader, the Bible says that we should not become weary in doing good works, because in time we will see a harvest if we keep on doing what we've been called to do. That's Galatians 6:9. Paul wrote those words to encourage leaders in Galatia who felt discouraged because they felt like they were spinning their wheels and they didn't feel like they were making an impact. So the truth is, for each of us today, maybe you feel like you're spinning your wheels. Well, as you are continuing to lead people, you don't know how God is using those voicemails, those emails, those texts to help people feel connected where they are, even though they're not responding to them. I want to encourage you that God is indeed doing that, and that through your actions, you're helping people feel more connected than they otherwise would feel. And so don't give up. Keep on doing what you're doing. If you need encouragement personally, reach out to me. I'll be more than glad to talk with you, to encourage you, but also know you're not alone. A lot of other leaders in our church are feeling the same things as you are trying to do everything you can do to encourage everyone in your group. Know that you are not alone. Know that God loves you and God has a good plan for you. I'd like to end by praying for each of us. Lord, I pray that you would cover over us as leaders. Lord, may you help us to feel like we are making a difference. I thank you, Lord, for this promise in Galatians, that as we continue to do good deeds and do good works, that you will use those to invest in others, and we'll see a harvest in due time. I pray, Lord, that we would see a harvest even sooner than later. That people would start coming around and just say thank you for the texts or emails or whatever means we're using to encourage other people around us. I pray, Lord, that you would help our groups to continue to grow closer to you. And I pray, Lord, that you would help each of my friends who are leading to feel encouraged today. May your peace and your presence cover them and surround them. May you remind them of the impact that you are using them to have in the lives of other people. But also, Lord, I pray that you would grow them. Lord, may you encourage them and strengthen them today. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I hope that you have a wonderful day today, and thank you so much for leading. Hey, God bless.